Okay, our last video is going to be on graphing. So you do not have to do 26 and 27 because we did not make that on this particular test. Let's go on to 28 though, because 28 is one that you do have to do. Okay, so we have to find each of these things for our graph as I look at x plus 5 over x plus 2. So let's start with the vertical asymptote. So what is the zero of the denominator? What would make this zero? I would need negative 2 there, right? So my vertical asymptote is, don't just put this, okay? You lose communication points. You put x equals negative 2. So let's go ahead and make that vertical asymptote. Now this isn't part of the graph, this is an asymptote. Okay, so you make it a dotted line. All right, moving on. Let's go ahead and find the horizontal asymptote, okay? So remember, you can always get the horizontal asymptote by dividing the first two coefficients because the degrees are the same, okay? So this is like 1 over 1. So the horizontal asymptote is y equals 1. Let's go ahead and draw that in. All right. My x-intercept is the zero of the numerator, okay? Well, what is the zero of the numerator? Well, that would be, if I have x plus 5, what would make it zero? Well, that would be negative 5, okay? So my x-intercept is negative 5. Let's go ahead and put a dot there. I'll use a different color, because this is actually part of the graph, remember? So my x-intercept is negative 5, comma, 0. Now, if you see the shown work that I have over here on the left, that shows me that you didn't just copy or plug this into Desmos. That showed me how you got it. And that's going to be very important on the test, okay? When you go to take that test on your own. So my 0 for the numerator could have been, okay, what would make that 0? Well, it's negative 2. This shows understanding, okay? So that's the kind of thing that you're going to go for there. There's not a hole in this graph. The reason why there's not a hole is because there's nothing that simplifies that's common, okay? Remember, a hole would look like this. If I had that, you'd have a hole at negative 5, but we don't. So that's just none. And the domain of my graph, well, what can x be? It looks to me like x is all real numbers except for, actually, before we do domain and range, let's go ahead and graph this. So this one is going to go like this, okay? We knew that that graph was below because of the x-intercept. Now we need to decide if this is in region 1 or if it is in region 2. Now most of us can probably take an educated guess that that it is actually in region 2. But what we want to do to confirm that is we want to plug in an x value that's going to tell us something. So I could choose 2, 3, 4, doesn't matter. Let's do 2. Or I could even do 1. Okay, let's do 1 and let's see if we get a positive number or if we get a negative number. So when I put 1 into the function, I would get 1 plus 5 over 1 plus 2, which simplifies to the number 2. So that tells me that this graph goes through the point 1, 2. And now you can see how the graph is up in this region here. So the domain of this graph would be all real, except what? What can't x be? Well, it can't be negative 2. All real but negative 2, because there's an asymptote there. The range, so it looks like it can be all these things up, but then we have a problem right here. Where's that problem at? That problem is, it'd be all real but the number 1. Okay, then that problem is finished. Okay, use your answer key for these. Please, please, please use your answer key as you work your way through these today, and I will choose one more. Let's see, I'm going to choose, what's a good one to do that be a little more difficult? I like 30. Let's do 30. Okay, so with all of these, I need to simplify the top and the bottom. So I need to turn the numerator into this, Okay. I think you guys know how to do that by now, so I won't over-explain that. And then I'm going to turn the denominator into what this simplifies to. And then you can see my x minus 3s are going to go away, and I'm going to be left with this. Okay? Now, what did we just find? We found a hole. There's a hole in this graph, because x minus 3 and x minus 3, those are going to disappear. Those are going to go away. So I have a hole at the number 3. Okay? So that's where my hole is going to be. So my hole is that when x is 3, this thing is undefined. Okay? Because if I put 3 here, I would have 0 as a denominator, and you can't divide by 0. But our work is not done. What's the y value at this hole? Well, I would plug 3 into my simplified function. In other words, I would take the number 3, I put it here, and I put it here. So that's going to give me f of x is equal to, well, what do I get if I put 3 there? I get 3 minus 8. What is 3 minus 8? It's negative 5. And then that's going to be over 3 plus 3, which is 6. So that means my y value is negative 5/6. Okay, that's my hole in the graph. All right, that was probably the hardest part of this problem. Okay, but show me that work. Okay, that shows me, if I don't see anything over here, I'll know you just plugged it into Desmos. Okay, so you got to show me thinking. All right, let's find the x. Well, let's find the vertical asymptote. And while we're here, why don't we put the hole in? So 3 negative 5 sixth would be right there. Okay. Well, my vertical asymptote is the 0 of the denominator. So what would make our denominator 0? And I'm just going to circle this because this is the function that we're dealing with now. Well, that would be negative 3, right? So there's my vertical asymptote. My horizontal asymptote is going to be just like the last one. So my horizontal asymptote, again, if I divide the numerator and the denominator, if I divide those out, I'm going to get the number 1 again. All right, so my horizontal asymptote is y equals 1. All right, and my x-intercept is going to be the 0 of the numerator. What's my numerator? Here's my numerator. And it is 8. So that tells me that the x-intercept is 8, 0. Let's start marking these things onto the graph. There's 8, 0. We mark the hole. Let's mark a horizontal asymptote. And let's graph this thing and be done. Okay? I know it goes through here because of the hole, because of the x-intercept. So the question is it over here in region 1 or region 2? Because we don't know anything that's going on over there. So we have to plug in an x value that would make sense. So this is the smallest one that we can choose. So when I plug in that little pink dot, am I going to get a positive number or am I going to get a negative number? That's the question. So that pink dot right there is negative 4. So when I plug negative 4 in here, and here's another great thing to show over here on the side, although I'm running out of room. I got to plug in negative 4, which is going to give me this, which is going to give me 12. So this tells me that when x is negative 4, y is 12. So that would be like here, right? It's definitely a positive number, meaning this graph comes down and goes like this. So my domain is all real. Except what? Where is x no good? I'll use orange. It's no good here. And it's no good here. Okay? So all real but negative 3. It would be all real but negative 3 and positive 3. And my range? Okay, I'm coming up for range. The only thing that the range cannot be is the number 1. So the range y cannot be, it cannot be 1. So you'd say all real, but 1, and this y value right here, negative. 5/6. Okay, use the answer key and go ahead.